Hey, Jim here from K2 Concepts. We're going to shoot a little bit more of a detailed video. This one's going to be a little bit longer than we normally do. I try to keep them short, but this is more dipping difficult objects, and there's probably nothing that ever comes in my shop that's more difficult than Harley parts. I don't know why, it just is what it is. So, something like this headlight bezel, you could come in this way and kind of dip into the water, maybe back feed it, okay? But I'm thinking that I'm probably gonna come in this way, even though it's gonna stretch a little bit in here, it is what it is, and then flow through the rest of it. You're gonna get less of a chance of stretching and trapping air. Trapping air, I think people are acceptable of stretching a little bit because real carbon fiber stretches, but they don't like trapped air. So, for this one, that's the way we're going to go. What you're going to notice is that we have backtaped the holes here. The problem, if you don't backtape, especially the trailing edges, you're going to get burned. In other words, the pattern's going to maybe tear out here instead of flowing off onto the tape, giving you a nice clean edge. The other thing that happens is the pattern gets sucked in, so you're going to have even more pattern stretch if you don't back tape the openings, okay? And there's other things that can happen when you don't back tape the openings, as in the water can actually rush in and get ahead of you on the pattern, and I've gone over that before, but for Harley parts, this is kind of a more detailed video, so that's, you know, why we did this one this way. This one, again, a gauge pot, you can dip it a couple different ways. You can come in and maybe slowly start to back feed so the pattern doesn't catch air in here and eliminate your voids and stuff like that. The other thing that you're gonna have to do is put a little razor cut to let some air out of the pattern as it goes in. That way you don't have a void. You keep the water from rushing in on the pattern or stretching the pattern, but at the same time, you've got a little razor cut that you're letting the air out of there so you're not having a void. All right, so that's how we did this one. These, what I would rather do is come in, instead of coming in this way, the problem is I think we're gonna have a little bit of excessive stretch here. So what I'm gonna do is come in this way, back feed it a little bit, and then slowly go into the part, and you notice that I've back taped all the edges, so you're not going to have any tears and stuff like that. It benefits you to spend a little bit of time taping off the edges and other voids and stuff like that to, you know, eliminate those problems and those touch-up areas. So that's how we're going to do these, and I'm going to try to dip these real quick. All right, so I've already got the pattern cut, tank's up, you're ready to go. Oh, a little throw for the haters. All right, let's get it on. This is Brent over at Kansas Hydrographics. 501 carbon fiber, and this is the K2 Shelby Silver. A little bit of a tough time getting the pattern on today. I don't think we're okay, I don't see any air. Alright, I'm going to turn the fan real quick. And we're also going to demonstrate a tic-tac-toe pattern. So you're going to see me come in this way, and then this way, and this way. A lot of guys have questions, what does tic-tac-toe mean? It's just that, like if you're painting a car door. So you guys that are car painters and stuff like that understand the method and what we're trying to accomplish here. You're just trying to lay down an even layer of activator, okay? All right, let me put on some gloves and we're ready to go. Okay. Normally I cut this and edit it, but this seems to be easier just to shoot it all in one shot. Alright, ready to go? First one's the headlight bezel. Going slow so you don't trap in the air, but don't hesitate. Keep the feed constant. Okay, looks good. I got a little tiny bubble here, not sure where that came from. But I'll touch that up with some black, and everything will look good. Okay, this first one. Second one. I'm actually going to hit the timer this time. Alright, so this is going to be that second gauge bezel. This one, we're going to come in this way. Go very, very slow so you don't trap any air, and then come in and finish up. All right? Getting some gloves on. So part of how to avoid your trapping air is do little razor cuts in your tape. I think I went over that. A couple little trapped air spots, maybe one here, a couple in here. I think you can touch that up with a little black paint, but you can see that it all looks nice and smooth. All right? So, probably could have avoided some of that stuff if I had taken a little bit more time, but we're shooting a video, so that's kind of a factor. All right. Cut. Okay, set the timer. Let me wipe off my hands real quick. All right, now these parts, what you're gonna see is I'm gonna back feed in the bottom first and then roll into the rest of the part. So it kind of eliminates the stretch a little bit. This is kind of a, you know, so you guys are gonna get better at what you do. Let's put it that way. So, let me get some gloves on. And again, definitely have a little crumb for the haters. Now I'm starting to get a little stressed. Normally I take my time on most of this stuff, but I'm trying to make this real concise. So. Alright. Same tic-tac-toe pattern. Good day dipping. We'll talk to you later.